I want to talk to Helen.
Your lady's just fine, trust me.
Listen to me, you son of a bitch.
No, you listen to me, Jackie boy.
The Tyson payroll is going to be there in half an hour. You can have a chat with the missus just as soon as we get the cash.
I talk to Helen right now, or I call the police.
I don't think you'll do that. Love is a precious thing. And I think you love this woman just about more than anything else in your life. Am I right?
Please.
Well, it's not like I don't have a heart.
Jack?
Thank God, Helen.
Jack, please, you gotta do what they say.
All right. So it's the Marine on the county line road at 12 noon sharp. And don't forget, we're watching you.
So no stops, no detours, no phone calls, Jack.
If I see any badges, I'm gonna let you imagine the rest.
Don't mind them. So do you want the Freedom Day special or something off the menu?
Freedom Day special.
Daily plate for half price. Sort of our way of saying welcome back.
You can bring me some coffee. You got any cream? The real stuff?
Straight from the cow out back.
Bring me some cream. Lots of cream.
I'll lock up when I'm finished, Frank.
Sure thing, Mr. Davis.
Okay, number two over easy with English muffin. Number four with sausage and home fries. And a number eight, the Swiss cheese. Anything else?
Warm up on the coffee and more cream.
Think you can eat all that?
No. Just couldn't make up my mind.
Hi. I tried to meet you, you know. They had me sitting in the visitor's room for an hour before I found out that you'd already been released. I brought you coffee and donuts. Jack, please. You've had 5 years to think about and something to say to me.
The only thing I was thinking about the whole time, Leanne, was eating a meal like this and watching the Sonics play tonight.
What are you doing here?
I'm hungry.
Didn't I say I was going to bring you something?
You never bring me what I want.
That's because you eat garbage. Now get back to the van.
Relax, she's fine. I got it all under control. Excuse me. Want to bring me the piggies in a blanket with the hash browns, doll? A little bit of crispy bacon on the side?
Change his crispy bacon to a fruit salad and we're in a bit of a hurry, okay? Thanks.
I was better off in solitary.
Jack, what happened?
I don't want to talk about it.
Well, at least tell me why you never answered any of my letters.
I never read any of them.
Oh, you want to hurt me? Go ahead. Let's get it all out.
Leanne, I got nothing against you. Right now, I got nothing left to give you either.
I'm gonna go check on it.
Goodbye, Leanne.
You got a problem, friend?
My mistake. I don't believe it. You still have her.
Of course I do. You didn't think I'd get rid of her after all the work that you and Hank... After everything that we put into her, did you? I was hoping we could have Thanksgiving together, Jack, just like old times. I mean, I could even...
I don't think so.
But what do you mean?
I can't be part of your life again, okay? I'm sorry.
I want to make sure you're comfy back there, Mrs. Davis. Listen. I want you to know this is strictly a business thing, okay? So whatever happens, it's nothing personal. All right?
How long's he been in there?
About 35 minutes. Come on, Jackie boy, anytime. Will you quit playing with that thing?
Relax. No one's gonna see it.
You make me nervous, Del.
Everything makes you nervous.
I'm running this show. You got it? Here he is.
His grandparents in Seattle. He's never traveled by himself before. Maybe he could sit up close to you.
Mom, give me a break.
I'll keep an eye on the little fellow, ma'am.
Oh, thanks. I'd go with him, but I have to work, holiday or no holiday.
I know what you mean. Don't you worry. He's in good hands.
Thanks. Okay, well, let's make sure you've got everything. You take this. You've got your asthma medicine and your vitamins.
Mom, you've done this twice already, okay?
You've got your nose drops and your Kleenex boots.
Great.
Now, Grandma will meet you at the bus station.
No, Mom. It'll be fine.
If she's not there, wait for her. Sometimes she runs a bit late.
Any luggage?
Mom, okay. But
what's this?
You're taking me to soccer practice, right? I can't miss.
Looks like you're traveling a little light today.
No! You promised!
Sam, keep your voice down.
No, you said if I took this trip, I could play soccer this season.
No, Sam, I said we'd talk about it.
What? You treat me like I'm some wimp.
I just want to do what's best for you. We'll talk about it when you get back, okay?
You're
right. Bye-bye, baby.
Right. better than Doc.
Must be love. Won't be long now, Mrs. Davis, till you're right back in his loving arms again.
Shut up, Del.
Didn't think I'd give up that easily, did you?
What are you doing?
I'm going with you.
Jackie boy. Who the hell are you?
We're nobody. Who are you?
You've got about 5 seconds to level with us, pal.
I'm just doing what I was told.
One more time.
I sleep in the alley behind the bank. This morning, this guy says he'll give me $50 to drive his car down here and leave it.
Leave it for who?
For his wife. He said she'd be waiting here.
Son of a... I don't believe this. You better pray you know where Jack Davis is. Start talking. What's going on?
I don't know.
Del.
The bitch knows something.
If the bitch knows something, we'll find out. All right?
All right. Take it easy.
Okay.
Don't even think about it.
Listen to me. Your husband just left you to die, Mrs. Davis.
What?
That's right. I think there's a reason. What is it?
It's a stinking son of a bitch! I didn't deserve to die like this, Jack! You hear me? I'm gonna make you pay for this!
Keep your voice down!
Shut up!
Quiet! Shut up!
Jesus!
We got ourselves a problem here, right?
Yeah, I know.
Two problems, to be exact. One, two. We gotta make him disappear.
I can help you.
Help us.
Yeah.
You're the problem!
I know where Jack's going, and I know how he's gonna get there.
Mm-hmm. No. Keep talking. Go ahead.
So Jack's scared of flying, right? And so he's got to go to a car rental place, which is, what, I don't know, like 50 miles from here. And you have his car, and so that just leaves the bus.
Could have borrowed a car.
Yeah, or more likely stolen one. I mean, it doesn't look like he's coming back. Look, I know my husband, guys. He's on the bus.
Okay, he's on the bus to where?
Oh, come on. I'm not gonna tell you that.
You wanna live? You'd better tell us.
Go ahead. Shoot. You're gonna do it anyway. It's just a question of time.
Back off. It's all right. It's all right. It's all right.
What are you doing?
Doesn't matter anymore. Besides, she's right. She's right about everything. It's all right. Come on. Come on.
I know. It's nothing personal.
Buses left in the last hour, one at Seattle, one at Eugene.
going to Seattle.
If you're wrong.
I'm not.
I'm headed home for the holidays.
Yeah, and that look on your face tells me there's a girl waiting for you too, huh?
Yes, sir, my wife.
Your wife? Your kids?
Not yet.
I remember those days. You got a whole world of time ahead of you.
That was a pretty slick move, bringing along old Red.
I thought for sure it would do the trick. Wrong again.
Where is she now?
She's safe. The second you want her back, you just let me know. If I could, I'd turn the clock back.
Well, what's done is done.
I know, what I'm trying to say is, Jack, it should have been me.
It shouldn't have been either of us.
I know, but what I think...
Look, you would have never made it on the inside. And if you're waiting around for me to forgive you, there's nothing to forgive.
That was a private conversation. Hurting me.
It's supposed to.
I wasn't talking to you. It's not like I've got a place to run. How about untying me?
Why not? Are you out of your mind?
Don't you ever question my judgment again. Hey, Del. I think she wants him worse than we do.
How you doing?
All right.
I remember when they used to send me to my grandparents. Every time I got ticked off.
Better pick another seat, mister.
What's the problem?
You. I've been driving this route a long time, and I know a con when I see one.
X.
Lots of empty seats today. Find one.
Got it all wrong. But I guess I'm just gonna have to live with that. Sorry, kid. Didn't mean you any harm. You don't look too good.
I think I'm gonna be sick.
How's he doing?
He'll be fine. My boyfriend took me to the amusement park once, and we were having a great time until I barfed in his lap on the top of the Ferris wheel. You remember that, Jack?
Yeah. I'll be on the bus if you need me.
Is he really in prison?
Yeah.
Well, what'd he do?
Nothing.
Then how'd he get there?
I put him there.
How much longer are we gonna be here?
Till the kid quits tossing his cookies.
The boy's going to be all right, isn't he?
Yeah, just motion sickness. What are you listening to?
Dickens.
Dickens?
Charles Dickens. Great Expectations, books recorded on tape.
Yeah, Tale of Two Cities is my favorite.
Oh, do you read a lot?
Well, yeah, I used to.
Are you through staring at my breasts? It's a little chilly. I was going to put my jacket back on. If you're finished, that is.
got him.
Come on, pal. Pick a lane.
What's he doing in Seattle?
Tell you when we get there.
You better tell us now, damn it.
Or what?
Looks like Port Sycamore's the next stop.
How far is that?
About 90 miles, give or take, and there's nothing in between here and there, so we can just sit back and enjoy the ride.
I don't think we're gonna make it.
What are you talking about?
We don't have enough gas.
What?
We were just gonna ditch the van after we got the money. Why would we need a full tank?
We want a full tank for now, you idiot.
Don't you try to lay this off on me, Ray.
Look, we need a solution.
Shut up.
You shut up! All right. We're just gonna have to take out the bus.
Damn idiots. You got a problem, pal?
Yeah, I think we do.
Take a seat. Sit down. Looks like they need some help.
Don't stop.
What do you mean, don't stop?
You heard me. I said, don't stop!
That bus ain't stopping.
We gotta get out of here.
What about Sam?
I'll find okay, I'll take care of him. You gotta get out of here. Sam? What's wrong? You think you can make it?
Yep.
You gotta get out of here.
I can't see.
What, did you hit your head?
No, I'm blind.
What?
I'm blind. I was blind when I got on the bus. Someone's still in there.
All right, I got him.
Briefcase.
Take him.
I need to get my briefcase. I've got important papers.
I said take him! He's still alive!
Anybody else?
Nobody else made it.
Nobody walks away.
What's going on? I suppose those gunshots had something to do with it.
Yeah, I'm afraid they did.
Could they still be up there?
Who knows?
Hey, Jack!
Hey, Jack!
Mind if we join the party? We know you're down there, Jackie boy!
Jack, do you know these guys?
Hell no!
Well, they sure seem to know you.
How come they're after you, Jack?
I have no idea.
I'll keep them talking. You circle around from the side.
What about her?
You still need me.
Not the way I see it.
What if Jack gets away?
He won't.
What if he does?
What if she gets away?
Then I'll put a bullet in her back, all right?
Hey, Jack!
Jack!
We got some catching up to do, my friend!
We gotta get out of here.
What do you mean, we? They're after you, not us.
Did you see what they did to that bus? They're not the type to leave witnesses behind.
Damn it, Jack! You better answer me!
Help me lift them.
No, let's leave them here. We'll send somebody back for them.
Jack, it doesn't matter anymore.
You can still walk away from this, you know!
Oh!
You all right?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Money could be in there. What was I supposed to know it was gonna blow?
By using your head, that's how.
Slow down.
Can you go any faster?
No, I cannot go any faster. Or something.
A stick?
Yes, to use as a cane.
Right, okay, stay right there.
Jack?
Yeah, I'm coming. Here you go.
Oh, okay.
step down here.
What is that?
Come on, you can do it. It's just a step. One more. There you go.
Okay. All right. Just keep walking like I'm not even here.
I'll try.
Wouldn't be stupid enough to leave it behind.
You might not have a choice.
You wouldn't have left it.
Well, what the hell's going on? Why didn't we get that money like we were supposed to?
It wasn't exactly faithful, all right? Is that a crime?
Perfect. All the couples in the world, we had to choose you.
Knock it off, both of you. He's got to have it on him.
Let's get it.
Hold up and rest for a while. So let's hold up.
We can't stop now. They could be right behind us.
Hey, we don't have a choice.
Hey, look, don't worry about me.
See, the kid says he's fine.
It's okay, Sam. Sam, sit down.
Look, you're slowing us down. So she.
I am not slowing you down.
You got a problem, mister? Go ahead, take off.
Might be a good idea if we all stuck together.
What if we have a cut your name?
Webster. Frank Webster. And I'd still like to know why they're after you, Jack.
Like I said, I don't have a clue.
How come you stomped on the gas pedal? They definitely knew who you were.
Jack, are you sure you don't know these guys?
They were sitting behind us in the diner. I heard him talking. One of them sounded like he'd logged some time in solitary confinement.
Well, maybe they knew you in prison.
No, not that I know of. When I got up to leave, I bumped into the other guy, and I saw he was carrying.
Carrying?
He had a gun.
That's it. I saw them get into the van. That's it.
I don't know about any of this. I just know you got us into this mess, and you'd better get us out. She's slowing us up on purpose.
That makes no sense at all.
No, the longer it takes us to find him, the longer she lives.
Look, I want to find him.
We never should have brought her along.
She is an asset, Del. She's helping us.
How many times have we done this, Ray?
I don't know.
Huh? How many?
You tell me.
Maybe a dozen times, right? Always clean, in and out, no sweat until now. And tell her.
Maybe next time you do your homework.
She's got a point, pal.
Listen to you. Why don't you ever let women get in the way of business?
I don't want to hear about it.
She's way out of your league. She's been working you from minute one. You don't even know it. I've seen you. You're coming on to him. You're pressing his buttons.
What did I ever do to you?
Don't listen to him. He's just jealous.
Jealous? Jealous? I've had you pegged from the minute that blindfold came off. You just fan it out there for any guy who's willing to sniff it up, and then you rock and roll right over him. We're supposed to be on our way to Mexico. I'm going on alone.
Look at me. It's gonna be dark soon. You don't know anything about this mountain.
Sure as hell know a lot more about it than you do. Never used to be that way, Ray.
Del.
said about me isn't true.
Remains to be seen.
All right, it's getting too dangerous to travel. We're gonna have to find a place to spend the night.
Who's gonna sleep with the thought of them sneaking up on us?
It's not like we have a choice, Mr. Webster.
It's getting much colder.
Great, so we'll freeze to death if they don't shoot us first.
Where are you from, Webster?
What does that have to do with anything? You're the one that got us in this...
answer the question.
Seattle. I was in Horseshoe Bay on business, if you have to know.
What kind of business?
That would fall under the category of none of your business. I own a chain of laundromats. Is that all right with everyone?
Got a business card on you?
Yes, I do. It's in my briefcase with my wallet, which you wouldn't let me go back for.
Whoa! Help! Yeah! Sam.
Somebody help me! Help!
Hold on! Okay, hold on!
Oh my God, how are we gonna get
out of here? Let's get me a hand.
Help! Help!
Come on!
Please, please, I'm slipping!
Grab my belt!
Help!
Grab me. You got it?
Yeah. Help! Please!
Sam! Let go of the branch and grab my arm!
No, I'm scared!
It's okay, so am I! You can do it. Just grab on. Throw yourself up and grab my arm.
No!
Sam, we both know that you're not a wimp. Grab on. Okay, post up!
See what you do! Grab on and be a ball! Thanks. I owe you one.
You're damn right you do.
This is really nice, Ray.
Yeah. You know, it's funny, Del and I never figured on running into a bad marriage. So what's the deal with you and Davis?
I married rich, he married pretty.
You don't seem like the type who ever had to settle for anything.
I was waitressing at the time. Barely making ends meet, but I had dreams. Jack came in one day. He treated me real nice. Left me a big tip, and after about a week of this, he finally asked me out. I figured, what have I got to lose?
Think you got the answer to that one, didn't you?
You know what they say about hindsight.
I also know what they say about having your cake.
Well, let's just say that Jack wasn't the most exciting husband in the world. Woman has certain needs. You know?
Yeah. I think I do.
There's a huge hole here. I need, like, a big
one. Okay. Is that good?
No, it's good.
How's it looking up there, Sam?
Pretty good.
Okay, here's
that's a good one.
Really big one.
Yeah. I think that's pretty good.
Looks like they're stopping for the night, too.
Maybe. Keep an eye on Webster.
Where are you going?
I'm just gonna take a look around.
Are you married, Mr. Webster?
Yeah.
Your wife must be terribly worried about you by now.
Yeah, she probably is.
It must be nice being married. Having someone to share your life with.
Can be wonderful, yeah.
What's Mrs. Webster like?
She's an amazing woman, really. Beautiful, caring, trustworthy. I loved her from the first minute I saw her at that restaurant. I knew I wanted to spend the rest of my life with her.
You must really miss her right now.
Yeah, I do.
Are you sure we can't build a fire?
Forget it.
They might see the smoke.
Jack's back.
What if it isn't Jack?
What's the problem? Nice threads. Warm enough? Here you go. Put that on.
Oh, you'll freeze.
Only if I fall asleep, which I'm not planning to do.
Red.
A car. That Chevy is, was his pride and joy.
He loves you, you know.
Maybe he used to. Have you seen the way he looks at me lately? Oh my God. What I meant was...
It's all right. I have a slight advantage over you, Leanne. Nothing distracts me from the truth. I am confused about a couple of things, though. I've never felt a wedding ring on your finger. Yet it seems like you and Jack have been together a long time.
You think that Jack and I... Natalie, Jack's my brother.
Oh. Leanne, why did Jack go to prison?
Jack was a repairman in the biggest body shop in town. I was their bookkeeper. Jack got Hank a job doing body work there.
Hank?
My ex-husband.
Hank was the reason Jack went to prison?
He embezzled $50,000 from the shop and made it look like Jack and I did it.
And Jack took all the blame.
He was my big brother. He always protected me. The worst part is, I let him do it.
I think he would have done it no matter what you did.
Take it easy, it's just me. Somebody has to keep watch around here.
Get up.
Get up!
What's happening here?
Jack, what's going on?
I think you should ask Mr. Davis. Mr. Jack Davis.
What was I supposed to do? Give him all this money just to get back a woman who despised me? Who betrayed me?
You left her to die.
She brought it on herself.
How could you?
Easiest decision I ever made.
You make me sick.
Heard you talking last night, lady. Personally, I'd have to hear your ex's side of the story before jumping to any conclusions. Who knows? Maybe you deserved it.
I guess I picked the right guy to barf on.
Take off the coat.
You can go to hell. Take your hands off me. That is my money.
Something tells me it's not.
Listen, giving it to him won't make any difference in our survival. You know that. Besides, we can use this as a bargaining tool.
I'm aware of that. Don't make me ask you again.
Look at this. It came this way. Come on.
Give me a second, Ray.
Come on.
What is it?
Someone's coming.
Where?
Up there.
All right, everybody get down!
Moving, you're dead.
Please, don't hurt me.
What are you doing out here?
I'm just hiking.
Man, I am so glad to see you. It's all right.
Thank God.
Everybody, This is Andy. He's gonna lead us out of here.
Hi, how you doing?
Anybody hungry? You're almost there.
Ben,
a little bit.
Whoa,
a little bit.
Come on.
You okay?
Ben, yeah. You okay?
Yeah.
Come on, be careful. Got him? Yeah. Thanks.
All right.
So, careful.
Whoa. Check it out.
What is it?
It's some kind of bridge, Natalie. Is it safe?
Sure. As long as you watch where you're going. Now everybody follow me and be careful.
Stop staring, Leanne. I'll be all right.
Sam, wait for me.
Take my arm. Watch where you step.
Okay, hold on.
Is this thing got a hold?
Is there something wrong with the bridge?
Some boards missing, but we should be all right.
Easy.
Wait a second.
Dude, slow down.
Okay, take my hand. Run.
Just stay to the right, okay?
Sure.
We'll be fine.
You all right?
I got it.
Okay, Sam, here we go. Give me your hand.
All right. Okay, no, go ahead.
One step at a time. Come on, buddy.
Not too fast.
Don't look down, Sam. Come on.
Sam, don't look down.
That's it.
Oh, maybe I should look down.
Come on, tight.
Okay, all right, here I come.
Just stay close to me. I'll get you across.
I got
you. Okay, hold my hand.
There you go. That's
okay. I got it.
Okay.
You're there.
I got you.
No problem.
I'm fine.
Big step. There you go.
Okay. Thank you.
Big step. Big step.
Okay.
One more big step. There you go.
All right.
I'll bet you felt safer behind bars.
Yeah, it's a hell of a first day out, huh? Well, at least things are looking up. Stairs.
Maybe I'll get home in time to fix John his dinner. He must be scared stiff.
Who's John?
Sam, would you mind giving Natalie a hand?
Yeah, sure.
Give me your arm, sweetie.
Thanks. What up?
Be careful. There's a little step. He's my son, Jack.
My little boy.
I got pregnant just before Hank took off. I told you all about him in my letters, but...
Oh, God. I had no idea.
I think you'd really like him. I know he'd really love you. Jack? I knew about it.
Knew about what?
I knew Hank was taking the money. He promised me he'd pay it back. I was so afraid that I would lose him. It was all I had.
Yeah, I figured as much. That's why I never read your letters.
I never dreamed that he would do what he did to us. I swear to God, I'm so sorry.
It's okay. Come on, we gotta keep moving.
Careful, Steve.
Yeah.
Thanks, Sam. I got it. Thank you, Sam.
Everybody stay down. Take this.
Four.
Just in case.
Coming behind you, Natalie. Right here.
Thank you. We're moving. Let's go.
Insane, they're shooting at us.
Get going.
Don't look, Sam.
Okay.
Well, keep going. We're right behind you.
Me too, Sam.
Natalie, I don't mean to be rushing, but we have to move. That's it. Put your right foot down.
Don't worry, it's okay.
I've got you. Come this way, it's easier.
It's okay, don't worry.
Never should have gone on alone. From this point on, it's strictly business. You understand? Let's check out the river.
Jeff, what?
Hey, come on. Do you know where we're going?
If you don't keep up, I'm gonna leave you here.
Okay, come on, come on.
You're dead.
Sam, take a look in the path. See if you can find a map.
Okay, here's one. Okay. According to this, there's a dam around here somewhere.
Maybe there's someone there.
How do you know where it is?
Well, it's there, so... gotta be down there.
Let's move. Sam? Not bad.
Move with you.
Hey, kid. We've been walking for over an hour. I don't see anything.
If Sam says there's a dam, then there's a dam.
That looks like it there.
Looks good to me. Yeah, we can cross here.
You've got to be kidding.
I couldn't find any other bridges or anything.
Sam's right. We could go on forever before we find another way across the river. Leanne, you and Sam go first.
Oh, my God, this is cold.
Okay, I'll take,
Natalie Harris. It's all right, Jack. Pedal on your mind.
Okay, here you go. You're going in the water.
Oh!
There you go.
This is crazy.
Yeah, there was a log about 15 feet from here. Actually, this is good. Sun will go down. We won't be able to cross until dawn.
Is this the only way?
Yeah.
Are you okay?
It's not as bad as it looks.
Sam?
I mean,
okay.
It'll be okay.
So I just go straight.
Go straight? Go. You mean like this?
Sam, are you there?
I'm right behind you. Go too fast.
Okay, be careful. This is a really slippery part.
So, Natalie, where are you from?
Seattle. You
you demand my business card, I'm gonna push you off this log.
You don't run a chain of laundromats, do you?
I manage a radio station. Plays to my strength.
I bet you're good at it. Just past the halfway point now.
Hey.
You're doing great.
Careful, the rocks.
Almost home.
Find some matches and light the stove. There's a sleeping bag in there. Open it up and put it in front of the stove. Jack, we've got to get the two of you out of these wet clothes.
We'll spend the night here.
Okay. I got some wood.
Wait. I was a little rough on you earlier, and I'm sorry. Won't happen again.
I understand.
Passed out. Made it to the dam. We're in some kind of maintenance building.
Naked.
Don't be embarrassed. So am I. It wasn't my idea.
I understand. It's all right. It's all right. I'm sorry.
For what?
I asked you to trust me. And I almost got us killed.
I don't know, I think it was too much to ask. You've been trusting me the last couple of days. Besides, we would have probably ended up in the water either way.
I doubt it. Jack. What do you look like? I just want to know who I'm in bed with. You don't mind, do you?
did you get this?
I went to prison for Leanne because I knew she couldn't cut it on the inside. I thought I could. I was wrong. What about you? When did you lose your sight?
I was 10. And it was a car accident. For years, I was obsessed with trying to remember every image that I'd ever seen. Until I realized that the only thing I'd really lost was my sight. Jack. Am I? Am I pretty?
Jack, you gotta see this. Look at this. That's where we land.
Come on, let's check this thing out.
Do you think it works?
Sure hope so.
This would be our ticket out of here.
Yeah, well, who's gonna push the button?
You let me worry about that. The bad news is we're on the edge of a gorge. The good news is Sam found a way across it.
Morning, Jack! It's your wake-up call!
Jack, it hurts.
I know. It's okay. I know. Just relax. Relax.
You just relax. All of you. Just relax. Remind me never to take the bus again. Don't give them the money. They're gonna kill us either way.
Shut up!
Leanne, you think you can walk?
Yeah.
Sam, get everybody on the tram.
Okay.
Get out, get out, get out!
All I want is the money, Jack!
Just want to see his face before you blow his head off.
Fine.
I want my money now!
Just hang on! You'll get it!
You're the guy who killed my brother, right? Just want you to know there's no hard feelings. He was a big pain in the ass.
Okay, here he comes!
Son of a bitch!
Wait.
What? Ray, that's our money!
Where's this go, kid?
This can't be all there is. I'm all right!
Can you do something to help him? No!
I'm all right, get down!
Okay, here. Your hand.
there anybody in there?
Hello? Madison, please.
Hello.
Help us.
I'm out here.
Hello, is there anybody in there? Help.
He's waving.
Help.
Hey, hey. Somebody.
The people from the bus.
Yeah, we need a doctor.
There's a phone in my office.
Look, watch your step here, folks. It's pretty steep. Okay. Almost there.
To lock up.
Is there a first aid kit?
In the cabinet. I'll be right back.
Sam, find a phone. Natalie, call 911.
Okay.
Hold on, I'll set you down on the couch. Sam, come here.
I'm coming. Operator, this is an emergency.
Get the first aid kit out of that cabinet.
Okay. Yes. A bullet wound in the arm. Please make sure you send the police. The people who ran us off the road are still chasing us.
Here we go.
The ambulance is on its way. So are the police.
Great.
Right.
You're safe now. Sam, give me some water.
Yeah, sure. Jack.
Where's he going?
Excuse me. Did a bunch of people just come through here?
Yeah. Are you with them?
Yeah.
Is he out there?
Guess so.
Jack.
We gotta get out of here. Leanne.
Who's that?
I'm guessing that's Mrs. Davis.
Where's the money? Where's the money? Where's my husband?
Last time we saw him, he was running down that hall out there.
Take a seat. If you try to follow me, I'll shoot you.
Helen. Do you have the money?
Sure do. Take it personal, Ray.
All right, nobody leaves the room.
Thank you.
Helen, thank God they didn't hurt you.
How could you have done it? How could you leave me to die? What the hell did I ever do to you?
All I ever wanted was a wife. Was that too much to ask? Can I tell you what it was like? Waiting up for you? Worried to death about you? Having to believe all your stupid excuses? Well, all the time, you're naked in somebody else's bed.
You want to know what it was like being married to you? It was like living in an emotional straitjacket! Every day, the same damn thing, right down to the "Hi, honey, I'm home!" I didn't marry a man. I married a time clock. Want to know what you gave me, Jack? Boredom! You bored me out of my mind. I gave you so much, Jack. So much more than you deserved.
I loved you, Helen. I gave you every damn thing you ever asked for.
You're pathetic, Jack. You never knew what love was. You deserve this.
Put down the gun!
Oh, I don't care if you shoot him, Mrs. Davis. It's what you're gonna do afterwards that concerns me. Good. Now set it down. You should think about seeing a marriage counselor.
Supposedly made up.
Sign off and let the car go. Got it?
So, how we doing?
It's mostly surface wounds. You'll be hurting for a while, but it shouldn't last.
You heard him.
So, we still on for Thanksgiving dinner?
How about six? I promised my son he'd make the gravy. He hates mine.
You mind if I invite Natalie?
I already invited her.
You trying to set me up?
Actually, it was my idea.
I'm out.
Sam, thank goodness you're okay.
Oh, Mom.
Oh, I was so worried.
Jack, this is my mom.
Hi.
How do you do? I heard what you did. I don't know how to thank you.
Well, thank me. Thank Sam. Without him, we wouldn't have gotten out of there alive.
See you at the hospital, buddy.
Yes, see you. Mom, we gotta have a serious talk about Lincoln and Sawkins.
Hi.
I understand you're a Sonics fan.
Oh, yeah. Well, how much use for these?
My radio station broadcasts their games. Would you be interested in a couple of floor seats for tomorrow night?
Only if you're coming with me.